speak. From bbclearningenglish.com.
Hello and welcome to The English We Speak. I'm Feifei.
You are. And I'm Rob.
Hey Rob, a question. Is it right you have a friend who lives on top of a mountain?
No.
What about a friend who lives in La Paz, one of the highest cities in the world?
Strange question, but no.
Okay, how about a friend who lives at the top of a very tall tower block?
Definitely not. Why are you asking about my friends anyway?
Well, someone in the office said you have friends in high places, and I just wondered why it was useful to know people who lived high up.
Okay, well, if you have friends in high places, it has nothing to do with their physical location. They're people you know who are powerful and in an important position and are able to help you.
So these are useful people to know then?
They certainly are. Let's hear some examples of other friends in high places.
Wang managed to get a promotion, but I'm sure it's only because he knows people in high places.
Thanks to his friends in high places, my boyfriend managed to get tickets for the sold-out rock concert. Yay!
Despite failing her exams, Jane still managed to get a place at university. I'm sure she has friends in high places.
This is The English We Speak from BBC Learning English, and we're talking about the phrase friends in high places. These are powerful and important people we know and might be able to help us in some way. So, Rob, you know some very important people then?
Well, yes, a few, although not the Queen. Why do you want to know?
Well, I have to renew my passport and I need someone important to witness my application.
Oh, come on, Feifei, you know I could do that.
Sorry, Rob. You may be a friend, but you're not in a high enough position to do this. Look, it needs a doctor, lawyer or policeman to sign it.
Great. So how high am I?
About this high?
That low? Oh dear. Time to make some new friends. Bye-bye.
Bye.
The English We Speak. From the BBC.